Welcome to Google's incredible Spruce Goose office in Southern California, where I am for the Chrome Summit event. What's that? Oh, it's in New York City? Oh, sh**.
I'm walking here!
Welcome to Chrome Summit.
Welcome, everyone, to Google's Pier 57 for Chrome Summit 2024.
The day started off with a keynote discussing the latest advances to Chrome OS. Most notably, there's a new dedicated enterprise web store for extensions. You can now curate a custom store for your employees to view extensions that you recommend, as well as extensions that your company has produced and you want to push out to your employees. You can also customize the store with your company branding, as well as display announcements and curate extension previews. Next up, admins everywhere will rejoice. AI is coming to the admin console. Yes, Google has done a lot of work updating the admin console in the last several years, and even though it seems like things have slowed down a little bit, they haven't forgotten about it. They are regularly adding new controls to the admin panel to granularly control all of the AI aspects that are being added to Workspace. There are also tools now for you to be able to report on the usage of said AI tools so you can get an idea on whether or not people are actually utilizing and optimizing their licenses to Gemini, or if you should assign that license to someone else. Another super cool update that's coming to the admin panel is AI recommendations. Essentially, Gemini is going to be able to take a look at your admin panel and all of your settings and make recommendations based on your environment. And then from there, with one click, you're going to be able to enable said setting. Let's say, for example, it recommends that you set a homepage for a specific group or an organizational unit. All you have to do is click, and it'll do it for you. This is going to be a welcome update for many people that are managing tons of devices and settings throughout their organizations. Another highlight of the keynote was, of course, all of the wonderful AI features that Google has been bringing to all of their products. Now, one of the things that has set Google apart in their approach is how deeply integrated they're bringing Gemini into all of our workflows instead of just adding it on as a sidebar to their products. Now, initially, yes, it was just a sidebar to their products, but now they're integrating it deeply into the workflow where it actually becomes more of a useful assistant to save you time instead of just a chatbot. You have new features such as Google Lens, Help Me Read, and Help Me Write, which are integrated directly into the Chrome browser, as well as new AI features throughout the rest of Chrome OS. If you have one of the new Chromebook Plus lineup of Chromebooks, you get access to Help Me Read for PDFs, Welcome Recap, which shows you what you were up to when you left off, the last time you closed or locked and walked away from your Chromebook, and Live Translate. From there, they had set up various real-world sets showing the key areas where Chrome OS can be the most handy. They were medical, call center, admins, and kiosks/signage, and I'll go through each of those now. Another thing that helps me be productive is today's sponsor, Movebot. They're amazing when it comes to moving files from one cloud to the other, or even from on-prem into the cloud. It's really simple to just connect your storage into their system, nothing to install, select the files that you want to migrate, and away you go. You can even watch the reporting in real time to see that your files are doing exactly what you want them to be doing to give you peace of mind that the migration is going successfully. So big thanks go out to them as a sponsor for this channel. Check them out, movebot.io today. Now back to the video. The medical environment has long had cumbersome equipment, strict rules around data management, and oftentimes frustrated users who are far more focused and capable of human care than technology. Medical professionals are required to input a ton of small bursts of data as they do their rounds, often touching the same 20 workstations 20 times a day, logging in and out as they go. The longer this process takes, the less time they have for caring for people, and the more frustration they have with your technology. With Chrome OS Flex, you're able to speed up that whole process, because it runs on specialized medical devices. But what about the Windows-specific application that you absolutely must run? Well, we learned that's no problem with Google's latest acquisition of a company called Cameo, which is able to run your app virtualized. Lastly, in the healthcare space, there are a ton of screens constantly displaying information, updates, or even entertainment, and you can manage all of that remotely with Chrome OS. Next up is call centers, an area that I have personally deployed Chrome OS and have had excellent results with several of my clients. It's super simple to set up, lightweight and fast, and keeps your agents in the environment for that call. Additionally, Chrome OS has the ability to control confidential data security by locking down what can be copied and pasted where, watermarking the screen and screenshots, and more. Another awesome feature they showed off is the ability to have workspaces for each individual call. So let's say you're a call center agent, the call comes in, you are able to open up a new desktop workspace for that call, and any apps or windows that you open in order to input data for that individual call will stay open until you're done with the call. Generally, at the end of a call, when a call center agent hangs up the phone, they're given a couple of minutes to put in notes about the call and finalize any of the information that they forgot to put in throughout the duration of the call. What makes this so awesome is that with one click, they can end that entire environment, close all of the windows and all of the information from that individual's accounts, and move on to a fresh interface for the next call that comes in, and all of this can happen completely automatically. Not only that, but all of this is built with the cooperation of some of the largest call center providers in the world, so you get that real deep level integration capabilities. Next up is my personal favorite, admins. As I mentioned before, there are a lot of changes that are coming to the admin panel, and you guessed it, the biggest among them is all powered by AI. There are some school districts that have one admin managing 100,000 Chrome OS devices. That being said, there are different things we as admins need to be aware of and address from day to day. The admin panel is going to use AI to rise these alerts to the top of the admin panel so you can easily and quickly take action. Additionally, you have access to on-device data such as temperature, fan speed, etc., and you can use this data to predict issues in your space and when a device is likely to have a problem. If someone loses their device, you can remote wipe it from the admin panel easily. Next up will be familiar to anyone in the restaurant and retail spaces. Take a look around the next time you're in your favorite big box store or restaurant, and you see displays and kiosks showing information, maybe entertainment, and allowing you to check out or find items that you're looking for. And more retailers and restaurants across the country and around the world, it is becoming very common that Chrome OS is powering the magic behind all of those screens. I can't detail all of them, but there are some very, very large chains that are using or implementing Chrome OS, running both front of office and back office operations. One company I can talk about is Dominos. Dominos runs both front of house and back of house completely on Chrome OS and has 50,000 devices running across 10,000 locations. That's a lot of devices, and that's a lot of pizza. The world of Chrome OS and its devices and applications is vast, and I look forward to diving into the different areas in the coming weeks and months. I'm preparing reviews on some of the top Chrome OS hardware. As you can see here, I have two different options with me already, with more on the way. I also have a sneak peek behind the scenes tour of how Google certifies its devices for Chrome OS and Chrome OS Flex, as well as a video on installing Chrome OS Flex on an older iMac. Be sure to like and subscribe so that you don't miss those videos. And as always, thanks for watching.